Like Charlotte said, my name is Jason Stewart, and I work at the U.S. Plant City campus as academic advisor. And a little bit of history, myself, before I took this job, I taught agriculture, high school and middle school, for 13 years at Durant High School and then at Tomlin Middle School. So any high school ag students in here? Okay, good. And just to kind of get a feel for the audience, what grade are you guys in? How many out of high school community college students do we have? One, two. So the rest of you guys are juniors and seniors, I'm assuming? Anybody lower than a junior? No? Good. You? Any lifelong Gator fans in here? Lifelong Gator fans. Any Gator fans where your mom and your dad and your aunts and uncles and grandparents and everybody just grew up either going to Florida or liking the Gators? Okay, good. So we have some strong, passionate Florida Gator fans in here, which is what we like. So what I want to do today is I want to give you a brief little history of the University of Florida and the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences, and then we're going to learn about some opportunities that are available through CALS in experiential learning, research, and distance education. So just a little brief history. The University of Florida was founded in 1853, and it is one of two land-grant universities in the state of Florida. Anybody know what a land-grant university is? No? Jennifer, you know what a land-grant university is?
Yes, I do. A land-grant university is a university in each state that receives federal funding for research, for education, for agricultural studies. Usually there's only one per state, but Florida has two.
Well, there's two types of land grants. Okay. So there's a traditional land grant, which is the University of Florida, and it receives federal funding, like she said, to do research and basically start educating farmers about agriculture. So it began as a seminary and agricultural college, and our second land grant is Florida A&M up in Tallahassee. So those are our two land grants. We have almost 50,000 students annually at the University of Florida. 32,000 of those are undergrads. And your per credit hour is about $212. That's always a big question, is how much does it cost? About $212.71 per credit hour. However, if you look at the overall total academic education and cost of going to the University of Florida, we ranked second, according to Forbes magazine, in 2016 for the best value public colleges. We have 16 colleges on campus with over 100 undergraduate majors. And a little fact is, you haven't been here in 1965. I've got a little video that talks about it, but in the essence of time, we're going to skip it. So now to talk about the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences a little bit. We have a little over 4,200 undergraduate students and about 1,500 graduate students in the College of Agriculture, making it the fourth largest college on campus. There are 24 undergraduate majors, and you'll learn more about the majors later on from Miss Amy Emler. So I'm not gonna go into detail on majors, with 43 specializations, and this encompasses all of the different agricultural industries, forestry, natural resources, and life sciences. So anything within that realm, we probably have a major for you. There's also six pre-professional majors, and these pre-professional majors prepare you to go into veterinary careers, dental careers, med school. So if you want to go to med school and become a doctor, a surgeon, you can do it through the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences. Same thing with a dentist or orthodontist or a veterinarian. This I do want to show you, quick little video on, hopefully I can get it up right the first time. Thank you. there. And what about our sound?
We might have been working. We just sit down. What makes you good?
Even though the UF College of Agriculture and Life Sciences is the fourth largest college, and you saw that we have over 5,000 students, we really are one big family, and we create that family atmosphere where we have one-on-one department advising so that you get specialized attention as a student, and you don't feel like just a number at the University of Florida. Students will have the opportunities to work closely with faculty and even work on research projects if that's something that you're interested in. I was fortunate enough to have the opportunity to do that with one of my professors in agriculture education and communications. As for a semester, I did a little research project with him. So there are opportunities to work one-on-one and get to know the professors and actually do research with them. Your college friends, I think all of us can attest to this, that have graduated from UF, will eventually become your work peers. So that's pretty cool to be able to work with your friends. And who you meet in the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences, that is your network as you get out into the real world. And you will run into those people and work with those people. And it'll help you get jobs later on down the road. So building that network through the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences is very important. So, figuring it all out, one thing you need to know is what are the requirements to get into the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences. We do have a biology requirement, public speaking, technical writing, economics, so those are some of the requirements. You also need to, and Amy's gonna help you do this, hone in on what you wanna major in. Once you figure out that major, then go and visit the department and talk to an advisor, talk to the professor, figure out if you're going to go up there as a freshman, what classes you need to take, or if you're transferring, what prerequisites do you need, and find all that out prior to your sophomore year and ready to start your major, because all those classes you could take in those first 2 years. So you want to make sure you do it as efficiently as possible and save as much money as possible and only take what you need. And that's where your one-on-one advising is very, very helpful. Stay in touch as you go through your high school career and or community college if you're going to take that route. Remember that you can become a fan on Facebook, follow us on Twitter and Instagram, join the LinkedIn group. The contact information is up there, McCarty Hall, and I'm sure there's a business card up here somewhere that you can take, that you can hold on to, that has that office number on there. And once you become a student, you'll also get weekly updates from the Cal's Dean's office. So we try and keep you involved as much as possible and informed of what's going on in the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences. Some opportunities that I want to talk about, and I'm glad Shelby mentioned the study abroad. We're going to talk about experiential learning, which is learning through experience and reflection on doing. So it's going beyond the books. We're also going to talk about, and well, within that experiential learning, we're going to talk about study abroad, international studies, and Peace Corps. So study abroad, there's no better way to acquire a global perspective than to leave the country. And like Shelby, I had an opportunity to take a study abroad trip. Although I didn't go as many places as she did, I went to Costa Rica as a Cal's ambassador. And I can tell you that college is the best time to take a study abroad trip to learn about different cultures. And as far as what you're going to do, see, and learn in a set amount of time and a set amount of money, there's no better time than college. You're never going to be able to do that on your own and see all the stuff and go to all of the tours and everything that the college will have set up for you, as you will now. So the time and money and the opportunity to learn, there's no better time than college to do that. Some of the places that the College of Agriculture and Life Sciences sends students, and I don't think any of the ones Shelby mentioned are even on this list, so there's many more. But Belize, Costa Rica, Europe, Italy, Nicaragua, most of them have a theme, so I put some of the themes of the trips up there. International studies, so this is where you can kind of take your study abroad trip to the next level and take your summer or semester to places you never thought you'd go and receive college credit for it. So international studies can give you a minor onto your bachelor's degree, and in order to acquire a minor you would take 15 credit hours as an undergraduate, 6 as a master's, or 12 as a PhD. So to acquire international studies minor, you're gone for 6 weeks or more. So does anybody have any questions about international studies? You literally can take a semester off of college and study abroad and still get college credits for that semester. So you're not losing any time as far as graduation goes. And the last thing I want to talk about on experiential learning is Peace Corps. So UF has a very, very large group of students that they send out into the Peace Corps. It ranks among the highest in the country as far as Peace Corps recruits. So most students enter after completing their bachelor's degree, and there's a high demand for recruits with a background in agricultural and natural resources. A lot of times your Peace Corps students will go to third world countries where they need to learn how to grow their own food. So that's where our agriculture students come into play. So Peace Corps is kind of, it's almost like a mission trip, but instead of working for Jesus, you may be working for Jesus, you are basically working for, you know, your country to help better mankind. So. All right, some other Cal's opportunities. We mentioned research earlier, the opportunities in research. And as a land-grant institution, UF-IFAS is committed to research. And we have 12 research centers all across the state. And our faculty and staff has gotten over $167 million in research to help fund some of their projects. That was from 2015. So students have ample opportunities to partner up with faculty and work on research projects that are going to improve Florida agriculture and improve Florida's life sciences industries in our state. So research is very important, and there's lots of opportunities to do so. Last thing I want to talk about is distance education. So distance education is where you are taking classes or going to a different satellite campus other than the Gainesville campus. We have five different satellite campuses, and you can kind of see them around the state there. Distance education offers flexibility for students to get a degree while tending to personal responsibilities, whether it's family responsibilities or maintaining a full-time job, or maybe you just don't want to move all the way to Gainesville, so you want to stay closer to home. So distance education gives you that flexibility. So our distance education is a 2+2 program, which means you can't go to one of our satellite campuses as a freshman. You spend 2 years at a state or community college and you get your AA degree, and then you transfer to one of our education centers for your final 2 years to receive your bachelor's degree. We need to let some more people in. So you have the same academic standards, the same education, same student privileges as those students in Gainesville. So you are a full-fledged 100% University of Florida student. Your transcripts and diplomas are identical to those earned in Gainesville. One difference is since we are a little bit more flexible, we have afternoon classes. And a lot of times your classes are a blend of live and online classes to enhance your flexibility and minimize your travel. So for example, I work at the Plant City campus. We have students as far away as Fort Myers and Okeechobee that drive up to Plant City and are one of our students. So class sizes are small, and students develop close working relationships with faculty, staff, and their other students. Anybody have any questions about the distance education? And I'm going to let you hear from one of our distance education students in a minute. So some of the requirements: you must earn your AA. You also must take those tracking courses that we talked about a little bit earlier, and Amy's going to touch on. One common misnomer is you don't have to have a 4.0 to transfer to the University of Florida. So once you have received your AA degree, you are admitted based on your AA degree and your tracking courses and your college GPA. So that is what gets you into the University of Florida as a transfer student. Application deadlines I've posted for you. So spring is September 15th, summer AC is February 1st, and then summer B and fall is April 15th. And those are found online too, if you forgive me. Next, I want to talk to you specifically about Plant City. So that's where I work. And so I want to tell you a little bit about the programs. I won't go into a whole lot of detail. And then I'll let you hear from one of our students. So at the Plant City campus, one thing that, since it is a distance education campus, we cannot offer all of the majors that we offer in University of Florida Gainesville. So what we do is we choose two or three or four majors that are relevant to the area that the campus is located. So for Plant City, these majors, there's a lot of jobs around the area that can be filled with graduates from these programs. So that's why they were chosen. So we have four degrees with five specializations. Our first degree is Agricultural Education and Communications. And you can specialize in the teaching route, which is education, or you can specialize in the communications route, which is communication and leadership development. Environmental management, this is a degree that prepares you for going out into environmental resources or environmental sciences type career. This is the only degree that we have that you won't physically come to campus to take classes and it is an online degree, so you apply through the UF Online School, and you can take this degree 100% online. The next two, we have Food and Resource Economics. So Food and Resource Economics is a degree that we're really excited about. We have not started this degree yet. We are starting spring 2018, so we're hiring a faculty member to teach those courses. And Food and Resource Economics is it's a business degree with a focus on the food and agricultural aspects of marketing and management. So your actual specialization is food and agribusiness, marketing and management. I have a minor in food and resource economics, and then I also did my master's in agribusiness. So my degrees are from the AEC, Ag Education Communications, and Food and Resource Economics. And then finally, we have geomatics. Does anybody know what geomatics is? Don't be shy. Adults, y'all can raise your hands too. Who knows what geomatics is?
Surveying and mapping.
Okay, surveying and mapping. Good job. So, surveying and mapping the land. So, geo, you're dealing with the land. And you are mapping the land, surveying the land, and then learning how to read those maps and figure out how to put in subdivisions and build farms and all this stuff that we need to use all this surveying equipment for. It doesn't have to be on land, it can be in the water. So there's marine geomatics, and there's a really cool video on YouTube. If you just type in UF geomatics, it'll probably pop up if you want to learn more about the geomatics field. But there is a critical need, high demand for graduates in geomatics. So, which is why not only is geomatics at the Plant City campus, but it's also at Apopka and Fort Lauderdale and Gainesville. So we have four different campuses where you can get this degree because it's a critical need. And the pay is really good. It's anywhere from starting pay $50,000 to $80,000. And within 4 or 5 years, half of our graduates are taking over companies or becoming partners in a company. So it is a really, really good field to go into. And there's two different tracks. You've got surveying and mapping, and then also the geospatial analysis, which is more working with drones and mapping using drones and geographic information systems. So, if you are interested in earning a UF degree in West Central Florida, for more information, we do have a booth right back there, and you can visit us throughout the day or during lunch, during your free time. You can call, email, we can set up a visit, and there's my contact information. I've got cards here with me. Other than that, I'm done. So, thank you guys very much. And